a sweet dream to soothe me when I can't fall asleep. You're the field in the middle of the city. I'm rushing by the speed of light. You're the strong resolution when I find no peace. You're the church bells ringing in the evening. When all is quiet, you whisper comfort, lifts my heart, can get so weak.
You're the center of my universe. Good morning and welcome, or I should say, I guess, good afternoon and welcome, as we come together, the Joe and Jennifer, the Phong and Jung. For those who are Vietnamese, I apologize that I do not speak your language, and I know those who speak English and Vietnamese will be speaking to you to let you know what I'm saying as I go along. And for those of you who do speak English, I apologize, you all know how long-winded I can be. It's wonderful that we're here today. I welcome everyone in a very special way, Han and Thu Yen, who will serve as the best man and maid of honor for this beautiful couple who will unite today in holy matrimony. And so we pray in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Father, hear our prayers for Joe and Jennifer, Phong and Jung, who today are united in holy marriage, in sacramental marriage, before your sacred altar. We ask, O Father, that you give them your blessing, and that each and every day, beginning now, you strengthen the love that they share, the love that they have, the commitment that they are making to each other. We ask you this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
And let us now be seated comfortably, and it is my honor to invite Heather to come forward and to read to us from the Old Testament.
A reading from the book of Proverbs. When one finds a worthy wife, her value is far beyond pearls. Her husband, entrusting his heart to her, has an unfailing prize. She brings him good and not evil all the days of her life. She obtains wool and flax and makes cloth with skillful hands. She puts her hands to the distaff and her fingers ply the spindle. She reaches out her hands to the poor and extends her arms to the needy. Charm is deceptive and beauty fleeting. The woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her a reward of her labors, and let her works praise her at the city gates. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, you are compassionate.
from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, strive eagerly for the greatest spiritual gifts. But I shall show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but do not have love, I am a resounding gong or a clashing cymbal. And if I have the gift of prophecy and comprehend all mysteries and all knowledge, if I have all faith so as to move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away everything I own, and if I hand my body over so that I may boast, but do not have love, I am nothing. Love is patient, love is kind. It is not jealous, it is not pompous, it is not inflated, it is not rude. It does not seek its own interests, it is not quick-tempered, it does not brood over injury. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. According to John, Jesus spoke to his disciples, "As the Father loves me, so also I love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you this, so that my joy might be in you, and your joy might be complete. This is my commandment, love one another as I love you." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Why don't we be seated comfortably? I'm particularly honored to be here with you today as we celebrate sacramental marriage, as we celebrate the holiest of unions that we as human persons share when we come together as a man and a wife and come to a place made holy, as is this church, by what we do here, and invite God in a public way to be part of and to share with us love at its very deepest level. In the time that I have spent with you, Joe and Jennifer, Bong and Jung, I've come to see a couple who have great affection for each other. And I think more than that, while learning each and every day to respect each other, you've come from a far land, and have journeyed here and have arrived together, leaving from the same place at different times by different journeys. Yours, Joe, as a young child was very difficult, pulled from your family, pulled from your country, having the difficulty of being in a refugee camp and knowing the horrors that the human family can foist upon each other, and then fortunately being reunited with those whom you love and having the opportunity to spend time here with a family that loved you as its own and helped you and your sister to become more accommodated to a new place that was not of your choosing, but a place that allowed you to become the person who you are today. Now, we all look back on our trials, on our difficulties, as well as on our joys and our triumphs to see who we are and who we are becoming. And today, in a very special way, you are becoming whole in a way that maybe you have never been before. In that first reading, Heather read so beautifully, words that I think bespeak your wife. When one finds a worthy wife, her value is far beyond pearls. Her husband, entrusting his heart to her, has an unfailing prize. We've discussed the importance of commitment and love and sharing and being responsible. And I think both of you understand that and are ready to make that kind of commitment. And I think how powerful, when you make that commitment today, you are making it to a woman who has shown you tremendous devotion and love, has also had the strength to be the person that she knows she needs to be, and in a most beautiful and kindly way to lead you on a righteous path and to support you as she walks that path with you. And this is the role of a wife, to help her husband to be the best person that God has ordained him from all creation to be. And I think you the same have helped her to become accommodated here, to become familiar with the ways of a far country. And as St. Paul said, as much as she supports you, you say to her, I have a more excellent way even to show you. And this is a great love, but also a great responsibility. She gives herself over in trust to you. And you open your heart in unfailing love to her. And it is a love, as Peter said, that is patient, kind, not jealous, not rude. One that seeks always truth and the good of the other. And you undertake today, each of you, that joyous journey. Because today, each of you become more than you were alone. You stand in this beautiful place, made holy by what happens here. You stand in this beautiful place, and you say before us, and you're surrounded today by people who love and honor you. But you're also enveloped in the arms of a loving God. And you also say to this God who loves you, I am ready to be more than I ever thought I would be, because I am enriched by my partner, who I now journey towards you, loving her with the love that Jesus Christ commanded in today's gospel. Love each other in the same way I love you. And we look to this candlelit today, and we look to these beautiful flowers, which lasted pretty well in the hot weather, didn't they, Peter? that beautiful candle is a reminder of the presence of Christ and of that unfailing light of faith that says to us, we are more than we thought we could be, and with Christ's love, as we open up our hearts to God, and if we open up to each other in true love, we will enjoy most profoundly the joys of marriage, but we will also have the strength to work our way through the bumps and pitfalls that are a true and enduring marriage. And those who are here who have endured marriage will tell you it is so worthwhile. But as all things that are worthwhile, it is something that requires work and diligence. I encourage you today to love each other. I encourage you today to continue to become friends. And I think more than anything else, that is what I have picked up from both of you as I have spent time with you, is that you don't just love each other, and that's so important, but you also like each other. And liking, if anything, is maybe even more important, because that is what allows you to truly become friends who not only care and support each other, but can look deeply within the inner self and see the wonderful beauty that each of you hold. Both of you have a sense of compassion that's come from times of difficulty. Both of you have a wonderful sense of goodness. And both of you have a wonderful respect for each other. Live that respect to each other each and every day. Share yourselves in love, but never be afraid also to share yourselves in truthful and even in difficult communication. Never ever let a day end in which you haven't said something good to each other. And you will find there are days when you have to dig very deep, because every day is not as beautiful as today. Love each other, support each other, be honest with each other, trust each other, and be worthy of that trust. And I think if you do that, somebody probably younger than myself will be with you 25 years from now, and hopefully again even 50 years from now, as you renew the vows that you accept today, and as you stand before a community that loves you, and say again as you say today, I take you to be my wife, I take you to be my husband, because of all those whom I have met and encountered in this life, there is no other person that I have met who says to me, you are the one with whom I will share everything of who I am. God bless each of you. God bless all those who have come here in your support. God bless this day. And now I invite Joe and Jennifer, if both of you would stand, and also Thantuyet, if you would stand. It is your intention to enter into marriage, yes? I ask you now to turn and face each other and to join your right hands. Declare your consent before God and before this church filled with those who love you. I, Tom, take you, Yom, to be my wife. I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you all my days.
Then I, Yom, will you do the same. Repeat it for me. I, Yom, take you, Tom, to be my husband. I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you all my days. It's my honor now to present to you, for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Bong Moon. You have declared your love and your consent before this church. What God has joined, let no man ever cast asunder. We have two wonderful ring bearers here, and they're going to assist me. Without them, Lord, bless these rings. I bless them in your name. Grant that those who wear them may always have a deep faith in each other. May they do your will. May they always live together in peace, goodwill, and love. And we ask this in Christ our Lord. Amen. Place this ring on her ring finger and repeat after me. You will take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Father, take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Again, let us show Bong and Young, Joe and Jennifer, how pleased we are that they have joined their love before God in this sacramental marriage. The lighting of the unity candle symbolizes
from the fire of Christ's love. It is a sign that two families come together. Here today, we have families that have come from afar, joined themselves, and are part of a much larger family, their intimate family, and also the family of all God's children. And we congratulate you, and we say, as with the candle of unity, may you be one now and forever. And now I invite everyone to please stand as we continue to celebrate this Mass. We have heard God's word in the Bible. We have felt God's presence in the exchange of vows. Let us now present to God our Father petitions for God's people in the world today. And our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for our Holy Father, Pope Benedict. We pray for our Bishop Paul and for all bishops and clergy everywhere that they may have the courage to lead the people of God to a deeper awareness and love for each other. Let us pray to the Lord. We pray for President Obama and for all leaders of government that they may be effective in achieving peace. We pray to the Lord. We pray for married persons that they may continue to give, to be able to forgive, to find happiness. May it deepen with each passing day. We pray to the Lord. We pray for Fang, Yong, we pray for Joe and Jennifer. They now begin their life together as man and wife. May they have that divine assistance that at every moment there will be support of friends, the rich blessing of children, and the warm love of others reaching out to them. We pray to the Lord. We pray for those who are sick, and we pray especially for those who have died, members of our own family, our relatives and friends. We pray especially for those who have been called forth from this life, who are friends of our couple. May they enjoy perfect happiness and total fulfillment in life and in life to come. We pray to the Lord. O God, our Father in heaven, your Son taught us to ask, to seek, to knock. We have done so, confident that you will now look upon our many needs, consider our trusting faith, and in your great love grant these requests which we present to you through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now I invite everyone to be seated comfortably as we begin the preparation rites.
Thank you.
My brothers and sisters, let us stand together now and pray. Lord, hear our prayers and accept the gifts we offer for Joe and Jennifer Bong Bong. Today, you have made them one of the sacraments of marriage. May the mystery of Christ's unselfish love, which we celebrate in this Eucharist, increase their love for you and for each other. We ask this in the name of Jesus the Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, all-powerful and ever-living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks. You created man in love to share your divine life. We see his high destiny in the love of a husband and wife, which bears the imprint of your own divine love. Love is man's origin. Love is his constant calling. Love is his fulfillment in heaven. The love of a man and a woman is made holy in the sacrament of marriage and becomes the mirror of your everlasting love. Through Christ, the choirs of angels and all the saints praise and worship your glory. May our voices blend with theirs as we join in their unending hymn. Given up for you. When supper was ended, he took the cup. Again, he gave you thanks and praise, gave the cup to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Your Son endured for our salvation, his glorious resurrection and ascension into heaven, and ready to greet him when he comes again, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look with favor on your church's offering and see the victim whose death has reconciled us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by his body and blood may be filled with his Holy Spirit and become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make us an everlasting gift to you, and enable us to share in the inheritance of your saints with Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, with the apostles, the martyrs, and all your saints, on whose constant intercession we rely quite heavily. Lord, may this sacrifice, which has made our peace with you, advance the peace and salvation of all the world, strengthen in faith and love your pilgrim church on earth, your servant Pope Benedict, our Bishop Paul, and all the bishops,
clergy, the entire people, your son has gained for you. Father, hear the prayers of the family you have gathered here before you. In mercy and love, unite all your children wherever they may be. Welcome into your kingdom our departed brothers and sisters, and all who have left this world in your friendship. We hope to enjoy forever the vision of your glory through Christ our Lord, from whom all good things come. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Jesus taught us to pray for the coming of the kingdom. Let us now, with courage, offering our prayers for our newly married couple, stand and pray using the words that Jesus gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ, for the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom where you live forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Amen. And let us offer to each other a sign of Christ's peace. Christ, our Lord and Savior, the risen Christ who takes away the sin of the world, how blessed are we who are called forth to share your presence. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you. Only say the word, and I shall be healed. For the sacrament of Eucharist, I will be communicating the wedding couple and the best man, the maid of honor first, and then I will come around behind and you can come up, those who are coming to confession, if you come up through the center, and then return by the side aisles.
This is the day the Lord has made.
continued blessing upon this bridegroom and his bride. Holy Father, Creator of the universe, maker of man and woman in your own likeness, source of blessing for married life, we humbly pray to you for this woman today is united with her husband, this man, in the sacrament of marriage. May your fullest blessing come upon her and her husband, so that they may together rejoice in your gift of married love. May they enrich your church with their children. Lord, may they both praise you in happiness. May they turn to you in sorrow. May they be glad that you are with them in their work, and may they know that you are with them in their need. May they pray to you in the community of the church and be your witnesses in our world. May they reach old age in the company of their friends, and at last come into the kingdom of heaven at the appointed time. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And I'm going to ask everyone to please remain seated for a few minutes as Fong and Young dedicate their marriage to the Blessed Virgin, Saint Joseph, and the baby Jesus. Almighty God, may the sacrifice we have offered here today and the Eucharist that we have shared strengthen the love of Joe and Jennifer Arnon-Jung and give us all your fatherly aid. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And now if I can invite you to be seated one more time, and I would like to invite Frank to come forward, who would like to speak to you on behalf of the family.
Kính thưa quý ông bà và các anh chị em, chúng tôi thành thực cảm ơn quý ông bà đã bớt chút thời giờ đến tham dự buổi thánh lễ cầu hôn của con chúng tôi. Và tôi xin cảm ơn cha Patrick, Mr. Mary, em và Mr. Driver đã cho chúng tôi một thánh lễ thật là long trọng để cầu hôn cho con của chúng tôi. Và sau buổi anh thánh lễ này, xin mời quý ông bà, thân nhân của hai bên cùng tất cả bạn bè, con cháu đến tham dự buổi cơm thân mật tại nhà hàng Đi Lan Trì của chúng tôi vào lúc 5:30. Tôi xin thân mật cảm ơn.
I will now repeat for
for you in Vietnamese. No, I'm just kidding. In English. What my father say in Vietnamese, my wife and I would like to say a few words of gratitude to our family and fans for attending this wonderful occasion. And to all those unable to be with us today, I want you to know you are still spiritually part of this blessed occasion. First, thank you, Father Patrick, for making my son and daughter Mary's ceremony special, and to Lady of the Virgin, Miss Mary Ann and Mr. Reese, for making the ceremony sound so heavenly. To my son, daughters, grandchildren, niece, and nephews, I want you to know how much I appreciate all your help in making this day the happiest it could be. I would be greatly honored if you join me for the 5:30 reception at the Dynasty Restaurant. Thank you.
Before we move on to the next stage of this day of celebration, I thank all of you for your presence here as you honor Joe and Jennifer on this beautiful day. I want to thank Joe's father for the beautiful words, Frank. God bless you. May you all have a beautiful afternoon and a beautiful evening. And now I ask you all to bow your heads and share God's blessing. May Almighty God and Almighty Father give you his joy. May he bless each of you with children. Amen. May the only Son of God have mercy on you and help you in good times and bad. Amen. May the Holy Spirit of God fill you always in your hearts with his love. And may Almighty God bless you and bless each of us here present. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, our ceremony is now ended. I introduce to you again Mr. and Mrs. Van Nguyen. Please kiss your bride.
A dream come true. So I'm standing here with my hand held out, knowing that your love will never fade. I stand amazed without a doubt, and I want to hear your voice in the morning when I rise. I think I know I'm just a normal man, only made of sand, except when you're by my side. Will you love me, teach me, don't leave me, I pray. And when I end up thinking of the times, your hands and mine together will stay. You made me better today than I was before, and now my heart can rest, and I will search no more. You made me better today. My heart has wings, or you take me away. And every prayer I've ever prayed was answered today. So I'm standing here with my hand held out, knowing that my love will never leave. My heart's on my sleeve, and now I believe. And I wanna hear your voice first in the morning when I rise. I think I know I'm just a normal man, only made of sand, except when you're by my side. Will you love me, teach me, don't leave me, I pray. And when I end, I'm thinking of the times, your hands in mine, together we'll stay. You made me better today.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Today is a very special day, a very happy day for Jennifer and Joe. Let's give them a big round of applause. My name is Ron. We're going to do the same payment. We're going to go on behalf of the bride and groom and the families. So thank everyone for being here tonight. Your presence not only brings joy, happiness, and encouragement, but it shows that you really care. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time I want to introduce the Flower Girls and Rivera, Fiona and Anna Marie. Michael.